many of you have handled in your career, in your professional LLP or prior to back-to-back LLP? Can anybody show and show a handle back-to-back LLP? So what is back-to-back LLC? Back-to-back LLC is a structure. This is my own definition to make it simplify. You will find it different thing on Wikipedia or Wikipedia. A back-to-back LLC is a structure where buyer one opens master LLC in favor of buyer two, who is an intermediary, who then opens a slave LLC in favor of main supplier, which is backed up by a master LLC term. To give an example, let's say somebody in Ethiopia buying fertilizer. SABIC, I'm sure you have heard of SABIC, Saudi Arabia was one of the large producers of fertilizer. But SABIC and being Saudi Arabia, they don't export to Ethiopia directly. Probably because of the country risk and the payment terms of countries in Africa. So there are a lot of large export houses who are based in London or Singapore or Dubai who become a middleman, and they are not a broker, they are large business, like you heard of companies like Bunge, Noble, Cargill, Olam, these are all are $20 billion companies who import and export. So the first buyer is the government organization who is based in Ethiopia, the second intermediary exporter are based in Dubai, and the producer is SABIC. So company based in Dubai, they get a LC from Ethiopia, the commercial bank of Ethiopia. Again, that LC, this company in Dubai open another LC in favor of SABIC, Saudi Arabia. So buyer one is Ethiopia, second is based in Dubai. And this slave LC going in favor of main supplier, which is SABIC. Now how does it function? What is requirement to open a back-to-back LC? The primary LC, which is the master LC. What I have done is I picked a few main points which is critical when you're opening a back-to-back LC. The LC expiry at negotiating bank counters and negotiation of documents is restricted with banks. Now, I'm not sure whether you are very familiar with these terminology of trade finance or LC, but I'll just explain you. LC expiry means LCs have its expiry dates, when you know what date they can expire. Negotiating bank is the bank who receives a document and discounts the document to the supplier. So always the master LC where the LC is expired, negotiating bank counters and negotiation of document is restricted with the bank. Charter party bill of lading to be avoided. So generally the bank who finance back-to-back LC, they preferably avoid charter party bill of lading. There should not be any clause that requires the beneficiary to substitute any other document except the draft and the invoice. Now, why these points are here is, I think I must share that there are a few banks based out of New York, London, Hong Kong, Singapore, who open a back-to-back LC without giving you a facility or a normal working capital facility. So, for example, maybe your group or any corporate based in Dubai or India, they will have their CC limit or working capital lines with banks, okay, based on the balance sheet, corporate guarantee or different collaterals. But there are banks who do a transaction-based financing on that particular transaction without getting into hassle of that, you know, guarantees and all. Like generally, you have to take 1 to 3 months to take a facility of bank anywhere in the world. But in this structure, if your things ready, you can have within week to 10 days, this LC can be opened by a foreign bank. There are very few banks who are expert of this, who are based in Singapore, Geneva. So in this structure, when they open a back-to-back LC without a corporate lines on you, they preferably want these conditions in the LC. Now comes the secondary LC, the slave LC. Bank prefer that amount is at least 10% less than the face value of the primary LC. So for example, if the main buyer in Ethiopia is buying fertilizer at $100, there should be at least 10% margin. So you will open LC in favor of SABIC maybe for $90. Now, I must share here that when the bank gives this sort of transaction facility to a corporate, they will do the calculation and see that you should not make a loss. Okay? For example, if the price you buy from SEBIC is $90, what is the freight cost? What is the insurance cost? What will be the finance cost of this transaction? Add up, you add up all that, should be less than 100. There are a lot of smart export houses or competitive players who play with this. Like, this is a normal structure, so they will not share what is the freight cost, or they will not share the insurance, so they will say, okay, I'm buying at 90 and selling at 100, so give me this. So the bank, the smart bank, and of course all the banks prefer that what is the freight cost could be and the insurance. The expiry date that precedes that of the primary LC, but at least 15 business days. So there has to be a gap of 15 days between the LC expiry of the primary LC and the secondary LC. All documents must not be dated later than the days from the date of the BN.